Hello, and welcome to the RADNOR Report for the week of February 27th. I'm Charlie Harper.
And I'm Lucy Bale. We'll have those stories and more in the show, but topping the RADNOR beat this week. Both RADNOR Elementary School and RADNOR High School present their musicals this weekend. RAD TV reporter Ellen Francis caught up with the cast of the high school musical earlier this week. Ellen?
What's your name?
Hi, I'm Katie Horner, and I play Princess Winifred the Woebegone.
I'm Hannah.
I'm Allison.
And what are you guys in the play?
I'm Lady Larkin.
And I'm the Queen.
What's your name?
Hannah North.
And what are you in the play?
I am the understudy for Queen Agravain.
What does she do?
She is a character that is really larger than life. She's an incredibly overprotective mother and I guess kind of like the villain in this whole show. So she's something else.
So the play is basically the story of Princess and the Pea, but twisted up a little bit.
There is a Prince Dauntless, and he has a very overbearing mother, and she's looking for a princess for him to marry. And she insists that he can't marry just any princess, so they put each princess through a Cirbiz test. And we see the 12th princess, and she just failed. And then I come in, and I'm a little out of the ordinary.
Are you the real princess?
I don't know yet.
What's your favorite part of the play?
My favorite part? I'd have to say that is a song that I'm not in, but it's a really cool song. It's called Normandy.
My favorite part is when I chase my wenches around because I'm like this like womanizing person. And I feel like every time I chase them, I feel like I'm holding a chainsaw. So, because I'm like.
Okay. Like, why should people come out to see it?
Well, it's really funny. There's humor for little kids, for the adults. I think everyone will enjoy it. Lots of big numbers that are a lot of fun, and tunes that you'll go out of the theater singing.
It's a really funny play. There's a lot of humor and satire on the fairy tale Princess and the Pea, and it's good for all ages to enjoy. Big, bright, colorful costumes and exciting songs.
And it's really nice to support your classmates because everyone here is obviously a RADNOR student. So we've had a lot of fun. We've worked really hard. So if you can come out and support us, that'd be great.
I just have a moment here. I would just like to say that this play has meant so much to me from the beginning to the end to the middle. It just really, I guess, I don't know how to say this, but excuse me. Sorry, I just get really emotional about this. Guys, I'm in the middle of an interview. You know what? I don't even
want to
say it anymore.
That's it. Come see us.
Back to you, RAD TV.
Bye.
To my mom, my grandma, my dad, my brother, my sister, my cousin, my uncle.
Now, we're doing an undercover mission to see what the play looks like from behind the scenes. Come on, follow me. Come here. Andrew. Psst. Andrew, say hello to our guests.
Well, that was wonderful, wasn't it? Actually, I'm in the show myself. I play King Sextimus the Silent, a womanizing mute king. And it's going to be a lot of fun, so bring the whole friends and family. A warm thank you to RADNOR businesses, local corporations, parents, community members, and RADNOR Township School District teachers and staff for their overwhelming support and generosity that allowed RADNOR students to win big at the recent A Winning Hand for RAF Casino Night to benefit the RADNOR Educational Foundation. More than $40,000 was raised at the gaming event held on February 11th at the RADNOR Hotel. This year, the event was attended by more than 200 RADNOR residents and friends of RADNOR. The funds raised support the efforts of the RADNOR Educational Foundation, and its mission is to supplement the traditional RADNOR education through grants for special curriculum programs and needs on behalf of all RADNOR students. Thank you.
Shop and mingle with friends for a great cause at the always popular 5th Annual Girls Night Out, sponsored by the RADNOR High School Scholarship Fund, Thursday, March 22nd from 4 to 9 p.m. at the Willows, 490 Darby Paoli Road in Villanova. The event takes place in a boutique setting and features informal modeling by Lily Pulitzer, incredible gift baskets, hors d'oeuvres, and beverages. Tickets are $25 in advance and $35 at the door. For more information and to purchase tickets, visit the scholarship website or send an email to the address on your screen.
Students in RADNOR High School Model UN Club joined nearly 3,000 peers from around the globe to debate solutions to world issues like cybersecurity, media freedom, and nuclear nonproliferation at the 49th Annual North American Invitational Model United Nations Conference held in Washington, D.C. Most of RADNOR students represented Cambodia and Egypt in the debates. The representation of Egypt granted the club an experience of a lifetime, a visit to the Egyptian embassy, and a meeting with two Egyptian diplomats.
So we just had a Model UN conference in Georgetown where we did really well. We won, what was it, six awards?
Eight
awards, and almost won the team award. And we have another conference in New York coming up in 2 weeks, or actually less than that, like a week actually. So we're planning on doing really well, and we're really excited for all our different committees. So
at this Georgetown conference, it represented everything RADNOR is and RADNOR Model UN is, and that's why we succeeded so well. At the Georgetown conference, you need unity, you need problem-solving skills, and just a love for international relations, and that's everything RADNOR Model UN has. And at this conference, there was great team spirit, unity, and in general, just had a great time. And wherever RADNOR goes, we uphold a great standard and a great reputation. And we brought it here, and it showed in our performance.
The club put on a strong showing during the conference. Juniors Shaiba Rather and Chris Blasey won Outstanding Delegate Awards. Seniors Sean Patney and our own Jamie Gorson, along with juniors Daniel Michelson and Griffin Unger, won honorable mentions. Senior Drew Calamaro and junior Chris Merkin received verbal commendations.
Don't go away.
We'll be right back with sports.
Be our guest. Be our guest. Put our service to the test. Tie your napkin round your neck, Sherry, and we provide the rest. Soup du jour, hot hors d'oeuvre. Why, we only live to serve. Try the gray stuff. It's delicious. Don't believe me? Ask the dishes. They can sing, they can dance. After all, miss, this is France. And a dinner here is never second best. Go on, unfold your menu, take a glance, and then you'll be our guest. We our guest, be our guest.
Beef ragu, cheese souffle, pie and pudding
on flambé. We'll prepare and serve with flair a culinary cabaret. You're alone and you're scared, but the banquet's all prepared. No one's gloomy.
Welcome back to the RADNOR Report. We now go to Abe Fagenbaum with RAD Sports. Abe?
Thanks, guys. Welcome to RAD Sports. I'm Abe Fagenbaum. With me this week is Hannah Rose Nussbaum and Hannah Shug, two stars of the RADNOR High School girls basketball team. Now, these two tremendous ladies just won a very prestigious award, but before we get into that, how did you guys do this season?
We did really well, actually. After losing amazing players like Chandler Lally and Kellen Friedman, we were a little unsure of how the season would go, but we really fought hard this year, every game, and we ended up being third in the Central League, and we made it to first round of district playoffs.
We did have some injuries, but we were really proud of everyone who stepped up to fill in for the people that went down.
Mm-hmm.
So the two of you just won the Mark Ward Award. I know that's been awarded to remarkable players such as Rasheed Wallace and even Wilt Chamberlain. Can you tell us a little bit about what the award's all about and how it felt to receive it?
The award is given to girls and boys basketball players in the public league. Originally, it was just given to players in the city, but they opened it up to the suburbs this year. Mm-hmm. And it's based on players that have academic and athletic excellence, so we were really honored to receive them because there's only one other girl there that received the award. So
it was really cool. It was like really intimidating to walk into a room of like 150 guys and then like be the only three girls there. I mean, well, we were two out of three, but like still, yeah. It was really neat. It was very, very cool.
So how did you girls find out, and what was your initial reaction?
We found out in December, mm-hmm. and I think at first, at least for me, I wasn't sure exactly what the award was, so I looked it up, and I was really, when I found out what it was, I was really honored to accept it.
Same thing. I was really shocked. I had no idea what it was, but just to hear that we were the first in RADNOR to get it, I was just like, really? Like, what is this? Like, yeah. It was really cool. I liked it a lot.
So obviously the team is going to be losing two great starters since both of you are seniors. But for younger freshmen or younger RADNOR students, how does the team look for next year?
They look really good. The thing is, RADNOR girls basketball has never been a team of basketball players per se. Like, we don't play year-round. We just kind of show up and do our thing. But I haven't seen a team that wants it more on the court during game time, and they will go hard, and they are all really amazing players individually, and when they come together as a team, they're really awesome. I think more people should go to the games next year because they're going to do really well.
Every time our player steps on the court, everyone hustles, and it's a great game to watch. Even though most of the people on our team don't play AAU or basketball year-round, we really give it hard on the court.
Hannah, I know you just recently committed to Franklin and Marshall to play basketball. What was that process like, and what's your expectations for the higher level of competition next year?
I was really excited when I first found out that I was going to play basketball at Franklin Marshall, and I am really excited to move on and play the college basketball, even though I really miss playing high school basketball. But
yeah. She's awesome.
Well, girls, thank you so much for coming on, and the best of luck in the future.
Thank you. Thanks.
Next week, we talk to Matt Pelton, who is a regional wrestler and perhaps moving on to states. Back to you guys.
Thanks, Abe. In addition to the Hannahs, Dean DeSimonian was also recognized by the Mark Word Basketball Club, but was unable to make our interview. So a big congratulations goes out to Dean as well.
Don't go away. We'll be right back.
Hard like liquid swords, harder than worldwide stadium tours. I am the future, DeLorean doors. Will it survive? Never decease. I don't think I'm ever gonna rest in peace. I'ma kill a game, leave the rest in pieces. Now everybody want my recipes. Tell a jealous chicken that I know what the beef is. I'm just making money for my grandkids' nieces. I'ma work hard, that's my thesis. 40-yard dashing, screeching. Pardon me, ma'am, I'ma go dumb, smart I am. I'm complicated, hard I am. I end the beginning and start it again. Or you could get this. You could call a demon, I'ma call Jesus. You could get a curse, you could get a cross. You could go to work, or you could be the boss. I'ma be the owner, like Jerry Jones.
Welcome back. The RADNOR Middle School Video Club is here visiting us today. Can you guys introduce yourselves?
Hi, I'm Jack Dwyer, and I am in 7th grade.
I'm Stephen Ching, I'm in 8th grade.
I'm Moses Wood, and I'm in 8th grade.
I'm Jim Fares, and I'm in 8th grade.
Hi, I'm Adash Yami, and I'm in 8th grade. We are the RADNOR Middle School Video Club.
Great to have all of you here. We hope you join RAD TV when you get to the high school. Original artwork by kindergarten through 12th grade students from RADNOR Township School District will be on display in celebration of Youth Art Month from Monday, February 27th through March 19th at RADNOR High School. All community members are welcome to visit RHS to view the charming creations of younger children alongside the extraordinary work of high school artists during the celebration. A special reception, also open to the public, will be held Thursday, March 15th from 6:30 to 8 p.m. The Pennsylvania Department of Education designates March as Youth Art Month to emphasize the value of art education for all students and to encourage public support for quality school art programs. Here's a sneak peek.
We now go to Jasmine Morali and Lauren Latimer with their tribute to the Hunger Games book and soon-to-be-released movie premiere. Jazz and Laura?
Happy Hunger Games! I'm Jasmine.
And I'm Lauren.
Each week, we're going to discuss anything and everything about the Hunger Games until the movie. Now, people are comparing the success of the Hunger Games trilogy to that of the Twilight Saga.
Right, but popularity is the only thing they have in common. The content and styles of the two series are completely different.
The two plot lines are polar opposites. Twilight focuses on the supernatural, while Hunger Games is based upon a futuristic modern society. Because they are so different, they truly can't be compared.
The Twilight movies, on the other hand, were a disappointment.
To be honest, they were a bit of a train wreck.
Hopefully the film adaptation of The Hunger Games will properly represent the integrity of the book.
Today we have some twihards, whatever those are, in the studio with us.
Ah! Oh my god, it's Twilight! Oh my god, it's Twilight!
I just get so emotional.
Edward, who do you think you are?
Are you joking?
No.
Don't
talk to me.
No.
I'm not
Team
your friend.
Jacob.
Rip it!
No, it's just PETA.
And we also brought in some people that are hungry for Hunger Games, as you can see.
There have been so many people that have read or are starting to read The Hunger Games.
And you should too, since it's Read Across America Week.
If you should read any book this week, it should be this series.
Yeah.
Cough.
Yeah. So go read. Now.
Happy Hunger Games.
And may the odds be ever in your favor.
Well, gosh, I love Dr. Seuss.
Me too.
RADNOR Schools participated in the National Education Association's Read Across America program this past week. We now go to Maddie Schutt, who has more on the story.
Thanks, guys.
Read Across America is an annual reading motivation and awareness program that calls for every child in every community to celebrate reading, especially on March 2nd, the birthday of beloved children's author, Dr. Seuss. Earlier this week, I met up with Dr. Swinehart, one of the coordinators of Read Across America, to see exactly how the high school was celebrating the joy of reading.
Hi, I'm Dr. Swinehart. I'm one of the coordinators for Read Across America. Read Across America is a day we nationally recognize Dr. Seuss. It was his birthday and all the progress that he has done with reading. So RTA, the RADNOR's Teachers Union, in coordinates with the National Education Association, supports Read Across America across the entire district. So at the high school, there are several ways to get to participate. One being you can be a guest reader and go to an elementary school, either read at RADNOR Elementary or Wayne, and read your favorite Dr. Seuss book to little kids. Teachers are participating by either marking down books that they want to read, that they're currently reading, books that they've just finished reading, and they'll be posted all throughout their classrooms and the school. We're also going to be doing a Dr. Seuss trivia contest, and the winner can win a Barnes & Noble gift certificate. And lastly, we're going to be starting on Friday, March 2nd, and collecting books all the way to the 13th. We're going to have a book drive collecting books that will go to schools in the greater Philadelphia area. Just as for me, one of my books I'm reading has to do for my class, and it is Copper Sun by Sharon Draper. It is great content, historical fiction book on slavery, so it's definitely a recommended read. She is a beautiful writer.
Hi, I'm Mrs. Pearsall, and I'm currently reading The Joy Luck Club because I plan to teach it to my AP students very soon.
Hi, I'm Sharon Reardon. I teach social studies, and I tend to only read nonfiction because, well, that's my job. And I haven't read, but I know it's supposed to be wonderful, Team of Rivals by Doris Carnes Goodwin. It's about Lincoln and how he had a cabinet that basically was made up of people who were not yes men. And he's one of my all-time favorites, so I thought I should read that. I haven't done it, but that's my intent.
My name is Leisha G, and my favorite book of all times when I was a child was Cat in the Hat.
How's it going? My name's Kyle Shulcock Elliott. I'm representing the math department, maybe, I guess. My favorite book that I've read recently is probably Freakonomics. It's an interesting assessment kind of on some social topics with a logical mathematical brain behind it, so kind of right up our alley from here, and I would highly suggest it.
Hi, my name is Mr. Laney, and I'm about to read 127 Hours Between a Rock and a Hard Place, because I saw the author speak at my niece's graduation. Looks really interesting, can't wait to read it.
Bonjour, I'm the French teacher at La Radnor High School, and my all-time favorite book, of course, is Candide of Voltaire.
Hello, I'm Mrs. Jane Heinbecker, and the book I'm currently reading is called Cryptonomicon by Neal Stephenson. It's a book all about cryptology during World War II.
Hi, I'm Mrs. Pereira. I teach Family and Consumer Sciences, and I have recently read The Art of Racing in the Rain.
Hi, I'm Mrs. McNamara, and I work in the library. I often see all your smiling faces every day, and I'm currently reading The Next Always by Nora Roberts.
We found out that Radnor High School has an actual true connection to Dr. Seuss. It seems Theodore Geisel himself helped a Radnor alumni, Jan Berenstain, publish her first children's book, The Great Honey Hunt, which spawned over 200 books in the now famous Berenstain Bears series. That's right, the author of the Berenstain Bears was a Radnor graduate, class of 1941. And during a week where all of us are celebrating our love of books, Jan Berenstain passed away at the age of 88. During her times at Radnor, Jan was the captain of the field hockey team, editor of the yearbook, and the go-to artist when posters were needed for school events. She attended the Philadelphia Museum School of Industrial Arts, where she met her husband, and soon after, the two worked as a magazine cartoonist team for such publications as the Saturday Evening Post, Collier's Magazine, McCall's, and Good Housekeeping. Seeing the joy that Dr. Seuss books brought to her two young sons inspired her and her husband to try their hands at children's book. And now we all know how that turned out. Sales are now over 250 million copies, and there is an animated TV show, toys, games, amusement park attractions, museum exhibits, and much more. Jan was inducted into the RHS Hall of Fame in 2006, and you can see her plaque hanging in the main hallway of the high school today. This year, the book series celebrates its 50th anniversary, so in honor of all Jan's accomplishments and in the spirit of Read Across America, read to a child this weekend. And you know, two great books just happened to hit the shelves last month, The Berenstain Bears and The Easter Story, and The Berenstain Bears All Things Bright and Beautiful. I'm Madeline Shutt. Back to you.
I didn't know Jane Berenstain went to Radnor High School.
I love her books. I remember as a child I'd read them and learn valuable life lessons from them. And to continue in the spirit of Read Across America, we go to Jamie Gorson, who will read a rendition of her favorite book as a child. Jamie?
Thanks, guys. When I was growing up, Goodnight Moon was my favorite book. My dad read it to us almost every night. He actually had the book memorized, so he could just show us the pictures while reading the book, because he didn't have to look at the words. He read it to us so many times. Now there's this new book that came out called Goodnight iPad, which is a new rendition of Goodnight Moon, and I'm going to read it to you kids. Goodnight iPad. In the bright buzzing room, there was an iPad and a kid playing Doom and a screensaver of a bird launching over the moon. There were three little nooks with 10,000 books and a huge LCD Wi-Fi HDTV with Boss 5.1, six remotes, and 3D. And BlackBerry ringing with Eminem singing, and new Facebook friend and text with no end. And a viral clip of a cat doing flips, and the bings, bongs, and beeps of emails and tweets. And a fed up old woman who is trying to sleep. Good night, iPad. Good night, Doom. Good night, bird launching over the moon. Good night, nooks and digital books. Good night, Eminem. Good night, Facebook friend. Good night, LOLs. Good night, MP3s. Good night, LCD Wi-Fi HDTV. Good night, Netflix remotes and Netflix streams, Androids, apps, and glowing screens. Good night plugs and power lights that guide us in the darkness of the night. Good night buzzing, good night beeps. Good night everybody who should be asleep. Good night pop stars, good night MacBook Air. Good night gadgets everywhere. So in the spirit of Read Across America Week, make sure to read to your child sometime this week and maybe do an extra book for fun. So I'm Jamie Gorson from Rad TV. Back to you.
Thanks, Jamie. I need a copy of that book. Well, that about wraps it up for this week's edition of the Radnor Report. I'm Lucy Bale.
And I'm Charlie Harper. Come see me in the musical this weekend.
See you next time.